Every company is trying to sell a story, and according to them, their company is the next big thing. But if you want to be a really good investor, then you have to check if that story is backed by actual financial performance. And for that, you need to know how to interpret financial statements. In today's video, I'll be talking about different financial statements and how you can interpret them to become a better investor. Let's go. A company mainly has three financial statements: the balance sheet, the income statement, and the cash flow statements. One of the main difference between a balance sheet and an income statement is that the income statement shows a company's performance over a certain period of time, and the balance sheet shows the company's performance at a certain period of time. एक आसान एग्जांपल से समझाता हूँ. बैलेंस शीट ये बताया कि as of 31st March इस कंपनी के नाम पे कितने एसेट्स हैं. और इनकम स्टेटमेंट आपको यह बताया कि पिछले एक सालों में इस कंपनी ने कितना सेल्स किया है. नाउ लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट अ बैलेंस शीट इज. अ बैलेंस शीट मेनली कंसिस्ट ऑफ टू मेन सेक्शंस, एसेट्स एंड लायबिलिटीज. एन एसेट इज समथिंग दैट हेल्प्स अ कंपनी जनरेट एडिशनल रेवेन्यू. अब दो टाइप के एसेट्स होते हैं, करंट एसेट्स और नॉन करंट एसेट्स. नॉन करंट एसेट्स वो होते हैं जो एक कंपनी के पास एक साल से ज्यादा होते हैं. आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट फिक्स एसेट्स लाइक मशीन्स, लैंड, बिल्डिंग एक्सेट्रा. दीज आर थिंग्स विच विल बी यूजफुल टू द कंपनी फॉर मोर देन year. Typically, when the value of non-current assets increases from one year to the other, it basically means that the company is increasing its production facility. To make these things simple, let's look at Asian Paints balance sheet of FY21. Asian Paints ke case mein, inka non-current assets 2021 mein kam ho gaya hai. At first, this looked like a negative sign because I thought that the company is reducing its manufacturing capacity. But jab maine unka note 2A padha, tab maine ye dekha ki unhone apna production facility badhaya. Lekin, because fixed assets ka depreciation ज्यादा हो गया, इसीलिए net non current assets 2021 में कम हो गए. Hence, it is very important to verify our numbers with the notes because notes to accounts contain detailed information of how this amount is derived. Right after non-current assets, we have current assets. These are short-term trade assets that a company expects to hold for less than 1 year. For example, trade receivables is cash to be received by customer to whom sale was made on credit. तो बहुत सारे customers credit में चीजें लेते हैं, तो वो जो पैसा आना बाकी है, वो आपका current assets में आ जाएगा. You want to see this number increase, and while looking at this number, you should also check how many days does it take to receive that money from customers. For that, you need to check days payable outstanding. Similarly, you want to see a company having an adequate amount of inventory so that they can cater to the demand as and when it arises. To check if a company is managing its inventory efficiently, we should look at the metric inventory turnover ratio. Next is equity and liabilities. You can think of equities as being whatever would be left over if all the assets were liquidated and all liabilities were paid off. It shows how much money the company has raised from shareholders, and it also shows the retained earnings, the profit that the company has kept with itself for future use. Next is liabilities. First is non-current liabilities, which are borrowings and loans that a company has for more than 1 year. We can see that Asian Paints has paid off a tiny portion of its borrowing over 1 year. Current liabilities are short-term borrowings due within a year, like trade payables, which is the money to be paid to suppliers, and short-term borrowings. All in all, whenever we are looking at the balance sheet, we want the liabilities to go down and their assets to increase. The next financial statement is income statement, which is also known as profit and loss statement. This sheet is your actual khata book. On the top are your sales. Of course, you want this number to be increasing every year. That's when you know that the company's products are as relevant as they were back in the day. But you want your revenues to increase from the core business. If you are seeing that the revenue is increasing due to an increase in the other operating revenues, then you have to check it out. The next section consists of all your operating expenses which were incurred in producing and distributing the goods and services. This includes cost of raw materials, salaries paid to staff, rent, etc. When we deduct this, we get something called the operating profit, also known as earnings before interest, taxes, depreciation and amortization, also known as EBITDA. तो अगली बार अगर आपके सामने कोई EBITDA बोले तो आप समझ जाओ वो operating profit की बात कर रहे हैं. After this comes our finance cost like interest paid on loans, followed by depreciation and amortization on tangible and intangible assets. And finally, we deduct the company's tax liabilities and arrive at the company's net profit or profit after tax. So guys, income statement is very, very straightforward. It basically talks about all the expenses and the income. The last statement is the cash flow statement.
statement.
The cash flow statement is what shows the true cash position of any company. Although the profit and loss statement shows the net profit, it also includes things like depreciation, which is a non-cash expense. Depreciation mein koi cash ka exchange nahi hota. It's just that the value of that asset is decreasing over time. Also, items like gain on sale of fixed assets are not included in the income statement. That's where your cash flow statement comes into play. The cash flow statement is divided into three parts: cash flow from operating activities, investing activities, and financing activities. Cash flow from operating activities adds back depreciation to net income and also adds any gain from sale of any fixed asset. It also includes changes in current assets and current liabilities. Essentially, this section shows cash flow from core operating activities. Next, cash flow from investing shows the sale and purchase of assets like machinery, land, etc. In investments ke interest or dividend bhi cash flow from investing activity mein aa jaate hain. And finally, the cash flow from financing activities includes cash coming from debt or capital contribution from partners. It also includes outflow of cash to loan amounts or lease liabilities. The net amount from all three of these sections plus the cash and cash equivalent balance shows the net cash in the business. Now that we have a basic idea of what goes into these financial statements, let's see what the best investors in the world look at before making any investment decision. Buffett likes to look at the data of a company for a period of 10 years. He likes to invest in well-established cash flow generating business. So firstly, in the income statement, he likes to see a company whose revenues and profit margins are increasing consistently. So guys, here I've opened Asian Paints income statement in screener.in. Over the past 11 years, revenues have grown consistently at 11.7% on an average every year. So this is a very good sign. Next, Warren Buffett considers gross profit margin of more than 40% and net profit margin of 20% a very good figure. Net profit margin is basically net profit divided by total revenues, and gross profit margin is basically revenues minus cost of goods sold divided by net revenue. Asian Paints ka gross profit margin hamesha 40% se upar raha hai, lekin unka net profit margin 10 se 15% ke beech raha hai, something which might not make Warren Buffett very happy. But I feel a consistent profit margin of 15% for such a big company is also not very bad. Next, income statement mein dekhna chahiye ki company ka debt bahut zyada nahi ho. For that, we need to look at the interest expenses of any company. Generally, companies should have not more than 15% of interest expense as compared to its operating income. To agar kisi company ka operating profit 100 rupaye hai, to unka interest expense 15 rupaye se zyada nahi hona chahiye. Low debt companies are always preferred, guys. Here we can see that Asian Paints interest expenses has always been low, which is a very good sign. Ye to ho gaya profit and loss statement. In the balance sheet, Warren Buffett typically likes to see a growth in the retained earnings, which is also known as reserves. Growth here indicates that the business is profitable and that the company identifies an opportunity for reinvestment. Asian Paints has surely delivered here with constant increase in revenues. To measure how efficiently a company is utilizing its retained earnings, we should look at a metric called return on equity or ROE. ROE is a profitability ratio which basically tells us how efficiently a company is utilizing its equity to generate more profits. The formula for ROE is net income divided by total shareholders equity. Another thing to notice is that generally the best companies out there do not require high levels of debt to grow and become profitable. I have already said it before, but I'll repeat it. Only invest in companies which do not have massive amounts of debt in their books. Next is cash flow statement. Most of the retail investors ignore this, but Warren Buffett actually always looks at it to understand the true cash position of any company. One thing that Mr. Buffett loves to compare is the revenue to the cash flow from operating activities. Isse ye pata chalta hai ki company ka jo actual paisa hai, wo operation se aa raha hai ya फिर इन्वेस्टिंग एक्टिविटीज या फिर फाइनेंस एक्टिविटीज से आ रहा है। एक कंपनी का रेवेन्यू मॉडल तभी सस्टेनेबल होगा जब उनके कोर प्रोडक्ट्स के सेल्स से उनका मेजॉरिटी इनकम आए। द नेक्स्ट फिगर टू लुक एट इन अ कैश फ्लो स्टेटमेंट इज द कैपिटल एक्सपेंडिचर। द परसेंटेज ऑफ कैपिटल एक्सपेंडिचर टू नेट अर्निंग्स शुड बी एज लो एज पॉसिबल। लोअर देन 25% ओवर अ पीरियड ऑफ टाइम इज कंसिडर्ड वेरी इंप्रेसिव एंड लेस देन 50% इज ऑल्सो एक्सेप्टेबल। देर आर एक्सेप्शन ऑफ कोर्स सच एज व्हेन अ कंपनी हैज टू मेक अ बिग वन टाइम पेमेंट टू ग्रो देयर बिजनेस। इसीलिए मैंने बोला था कि नंबर्स को देखने के बाद नोट्स भी पढ़ लिया करो। आई एम श्योर एट दिस पॉइंट यू ऑलरेडी नो हाउ टू इंटरप्रेट फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट्स एंड यू हैव आल्सो फिगर आउट व्हाट टू लुक एट व्हाइल रीडिंग दीज स्टेटमेंट्स। बट टू मेक योर लाइफ इवन मोर इजियर, आई विल शो अ डेमो ऑफ हाउ यू कैन पिक सम वेरी गुड स्टॉक्स। लेट्स गो। Go to screener.in, create new screen, and then add a few queries. Sales growth last 10 years, less than 10%, net profit margin of the last year should be more than 10%. Then we look at the return on equity. ये 5 साल का देख लेते हैं. Should be more than 15%. ROCE, return on capital employed of the last 5 years, should also be more than 15%. Debt to equity ratio should be less than 2. You can add as many metrics you want, guys. And as soon as I run this query, I get a list of companies. उसके बाद आप हर एक कंपनी को देखिए, उनके बिजनेस को समझिए. अगर आपको उनका बिजनेस और उनका मोट समझ आता है तो फिर इस कंपनी में आप इन्वेस्ट कर सकते हो. गाइज, नन ऑफ दिस इज फाइनेंशियल एडवाइस. ऐसा नहीं कि आप इन सारे कंपनीज में ब्लाइंडली जाके इन्वेस्ट कर दीजिए. That's all for today's video, guys. If you found anything valuable in this video, then please hit the like button. And if you are new here, consider subscribing. This is Anshuman Sharma, and I'll see you guys in the next one.